السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح
نحمده تعالى ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله أدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين وبعد إخوتي الكرام أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل كما قال سبحانه يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون اللهم ارزقنا الإخلاص في القول والعمل آمين يا رب العالمين رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said ألا وإن في الجسد مضغة إذا صلحت صلح الجسد كله وإذا فسدت فسد الجسد كله أَلَا وَهِيَ الْقَلْبِ Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said there is a flesh, a piece of flesh in the body. Is that If that piece of flesh is straight, the whole body will be straight. And if that piece of flesh is corrupt, the whole body will be corrupt. And that piece of flesh is qalb, is the heart. That's why Rasulullah SAW said that إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَى صُوَرِكُمْ وَأَمْوَالِكُمْ وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَى قُلُوبِكُمْ وَأَعْمَالِكُمْ. Indeed, Allah Azza does not look at your appearance or your wealth, but indeed Allah Azza wa Jal looks at your hearts and your a'mal, your deeds. One of the dua that Allah Azza wa Jal taught us in the Quran, رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا وَهَبْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَّابِ. And O Allah Azza wa Jal, do not deviate our heart after you have guided us and bless us with the mercy, with the rahmah from you. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَّابِ. Truly you are the bestower. Another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, أَيُّ النَّاسِ أَفْضَلِ. Which of the people are the best? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كُلُّ مَخْمُومِ الْقَلْبِ وَصُدُوقُ الْلِسَانِ. Every person who has a pure heart and is sincere in speech. So Sahaba, they said, O Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we understand the sincerity in speech, but how about, what does it mean to be, to have the مَخْمُومِ الْقَلْبِ, to have a pure heart? So Rasulullah ﷺ said, a heart is a pure when it doesn't have any envy, any jealousy. There are no diseases in the heart. SubhanAllah, we have been discussing this topic from last couple of khutbahs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran different states of qalb, of heart in the Quran. And I will just quickly mention 20 of those states that Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned in the Quran, different states of our hearts. One of the heart that Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned, one of the state of the heart, Allah says, Al-Qalb al-Saleem. And Allah Azza wa Jal, talking about the Day of Judgment, says, Illa man atallaha biqalbin saleem. Except the one who will appear in front of Allah Azza wa Jal with the sound heart, bil qalbin saleem. Another heart, Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned, is Al-Qalbul Munib, which means the oft-returning. A person commits a sin, comes back to Allah. His heart is attached to Allah Azza wa Jalla, comes back. مَنْ خَشِيَ الرَّحْمَانَ بِالْغَيْبِ. As the Surah Qaf, Allah says, وَجَاءَ بِقَلْبٍ munib. Oft-returning heart. Person commits a sin, disobey Allah Azza wa Jalla, comes back to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Al-Qalbul Mukhbit, which means a submissive heart. As Allah says, فَتُخْبِتَ لَهُ قُلُوبُهُمْ. الْقَلْبُ الْوَجْلِ. One of the sifat of the people of true believer, Allah says, الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. You know, their heart, وَجَلْ means a fearful heart. وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. When they hear the ayat of Allah, the ayat of Allah has been recited to them, وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. In their heart, you know, their heart fills with the وَجَلْ, with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. الْقَلْبُ التَّقِي, which means a heart that is willing to please Allah Azza wa Jal. وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. Whoever fulfills those شعائر of Allah Azza wa Jal, talking about Surah Al-Hajj, فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. Indeed, he is the one whose heart is willing to please Allah Azza wa Jal. الْقَلْبُ الْمُهْدِي, the guided heart. وَمَنْ يُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِ قَلْبَهُ. Whoever believes in Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide his heart. Allah Azza wa Jal will guide him. الْقَلْبُ الْمُطْمَئِنْ. Allah says in the Quran, the person who remembers Allah, dhikr of Allah will bring the itminan of qalb, satisfaction in your heart. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. الْقَلْبُ الْحَيِّ, alive heart. Allah says, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَذِكْرَى لِمَنْ كَانَ لَهُ قَلْبٌ. Indeed, in it is the reminder for those who have a live heart, whose hearts are not, you know, dead. Al-qalb al-marib, another type of heart, state of heart, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, is qalb al-marib, a diseased heart. About munafiqeen, Allah says in Surah Al-Baqarah, fi qulubihim maradun. In their heart is the marad, in their heart is the disease. Al-qalb al-a'ma, blind heart. Allah says in the Quran, وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَ الْقُلُوبِ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ. Indeed, their hearts are blind. The heart that is in the sudur, in the chest, are blind. الْقَلْبُ اللَّهِ, Allah says, heedless heart. لَاهِيَةً قُلُوبُهُمْ. الْقَلْبُ الْآثِمْ, the heart of the criminal. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the longest ayah of the Quran, وَلَا تَكْتُمُ الشَّهَادَةِ وَمَنْ يَكْتُمْهَا فَإِنَّهُ آثِمٌ قَلْبُ. القلب المتكبر, the قلب, the heart of an arrogant person. As Allah says, على كل قلب متكبر جبار. القلب الغليظ is related to the akhlaq of a person, how he talks and deals with others, the rough and harsh heart. As Allah says, ولو كنت فظا غليظ القلب لانفضوا من حولك. Or Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, if you harsh towards them, they would have run away from you. So القلب الغليظ. القلب المختوم, the closed and sealed heart. As Allah says, ختم الله على قلوبهم وعلى سمعهم وعلى أبصارهم غشاوة. A sealed heart, a heart that is sealed. القلب القاسي, the suffering heart. As Allah says, وجعلنا قلوبهم قاسية. القلب الغافل, the قلب that is غافل from Allah. His heart is, he has a careless, or a heart of a careless person. وَلَا تُطِعْ مَنْ أَغْفَلْنَا قَلْبَهُ عَنْ ذِكْرِنَا. الْقَلْبُ الزَّائِعُ فَأَمَّا الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ زَيْغٌ, meaning the heart that deviates from the right path. And الْقَلْبُ الْمُرِيبُ, the heart that have doubt in it. وَارْتَابَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. And there are many, maybe there are other states of hearts also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran. The reason, brothers and sisters, we are discussing this heart, this qalb, each one of us has that heart. Each one of us has that heart. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith I mentioned earlier, أَلَا وَإِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ مُضْغَةً إِذَا صَلُحَتْ صَلُحَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّ وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّ أَلَا وَهِيَ الْقَلْبِ. This piece of the flesh that we have, which is called heart, that is something that if that is straight, everything else will be straight. So we have to prepare that heart in a way that it can receive all that what it needs. We were talking about the nur of Allah Azza wa Jal in the previous khutbah. And the nur, the light that comes out of the heart, matches with the nur of Allah, that's what we need. The heart, the light of the heart, will be for us a way to walk on the day of judgment. The light that will come out from our heart. And as Allah says, Bishra, you know, Nurhum Bayna Aydihim wa bi aymanihim, from their right side, that light will help us to move on the day of judgment. And I mentioned this before also, brothers and sisters, especially now, month of Ramadan is approaching. In just a couple of months. And sometime, we just think that inshallah, the month of Ramadan, right from the very first day, I will be a completely a different person. And that's what our nature is. And that's what happens. Right from the month of Ramadan, the first day, we see a big change in ourselves. Our prayers are up to the mark. We feel connection with Allah Azza wa Jal through recitation of the Quran, through fasting and adhkar and sadaqah and all that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to do that in the month of Ramadan. But did you ever ask this question? Why it happens? Or we can analyze ourselves now that after few months of the month of Ramadan, or maybe after a few days, or sometime, wallahi, even after the very first day of the month of Ramadan, we feel that disconnection. All of a sudden, that connection that we had for 29 and 30 days of the month of Ramadan with the houses of Allah, with the book of Allah, our hearts were attached, we felt that light, that noor in ourselves, in our hearts. But all of a sudden that goes away. Why it happens? One of the reasons it happens because we did not prepare that heart in a way that we are supposed to before the month of Ramadan. You know, it's beautiful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Hajj. Just to give you an example, how important it is. Allah says, وَتَزَوَّدُوا. When you are going for Hajj, take provisions with you. So what kind of provision Allah is talking about? Money or those things that we will need? No. The very first part of the ayah Allah says, وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ تَقْوَى. The best of the provision is taqwa. Taqwa. And that is the purpose of the month of Ramadan as well. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So brothers and sisters, the question is, the one of the best way, for example, to receive the month of Ramadan is, from now on we work on ourselves. From now on we prepare our heart to receive all those barakah and blessing. It's just like a vessel. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he mentioned that if you have a vessel and you put a spoon in it and you taste it back, you will taste whatever is in that vessel, correct? Likewise, whatever is in our heart. Sometimes we say right from the first day of the month of Ramadan, the heart will be clean. But it doesn't happen like that. It has to be pure from all those sins that we are committing before the month of Ramadan. So it's that our heart is ready to receive all those blessings in rahmah. And so it can stay as well there after the month of Ramadan. So we have to think from now on, how I can prepare myself with that noor, with that light from now on, for example, for the month of Ramadan. What are the sins that I am involved in? That I need to get rid of those sins, one by one. So when the month of Ramadan comes, I am alhamdulillah ready to receive that special guest from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And likewise with the connection with the Quran. Why not to build that habit on daily basis? So when the month of Quran comes, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن, we already have that habit. We already have that connection with the Quran. So these are some of the states of the qalb, the heart that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran. So when we are talking about the heart, there is a heart which is called sound heart, qalbun salim. There is a heart which is marim, which is corrupted. The heart that has disease and doubt. And there is a heart that has some life, but still has a defect. What are some of the cures of the heart? When we are talking about, as we mentioned, different states of the heart, what are some of the cures of the heart? You know, the best cure is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the best cure for the heart. Sitting and reciting the book of Allah, pondering over the ayat of Allah azza wa jal, trying to understand what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking in those ayat can help us to cure our heart. أَلَمْ يَأْنِنِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَن تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَمَا نَزَلَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ. Isn't this the right time that your heart should be fearful with the khashya of Allah, with the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Isn't it the right time? As Allah Azza wa says, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. When the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recited to them, their heart becomes fearful because they were reading it. They were trying to understand and ponder over the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Righteous actions cures the hearts. The zakat, the sadaqah, spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can help us to cure our heart, to purify our heart. Leaving indecent actions are cure for heart. As Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and talking about the heart, he said, when a person commits a sin, what happens? A dot, a black dot has been put on his or her heart. And if he doesn't come back to Allah, doesn't repent, and commits another sin, another dot. another dot. And if he continues, then the whole heart is dotted with black. And as Allah says, كَلَّا بَلْ رَانَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. That they have the ran, they have kind of, you can say, the iron. No, in Urdu we say zang lag jana, on their heart. And when Rasulullah was asked, what is the cure of that ran? Rasulullah said, dhikrullah. Reading of the book of Allah, the adhkar, they are the cure of that ran. And why it is there? Because of those dots. So one of the sifa of the people of taqwa, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهَ فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ. Allah says, when they commit any fahisha, when they disobey Allah Azza wa Jal, the very first thing what they do, ذَكَرُوا اللَّهَ. They remember Allah, and next thing, فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ. They ask for forgiveness from Allah Azza wa Jal, and then Allah says, وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Who else can forgive your sins other than Allah Azza wa Jal? So this should be the quality of us as well as a true believers, inshallah. That when we disobey Allah Azza wa Jal, straight away we have to, should come back to Allah. We should remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should ask for forgiveness. This is one of the way to purify our heart, to make our heart pure. Otherwise, the heart will be dotted with black. With black dots. And Rasulullah said, كَلَّا بَلْ رَانَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. Dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also purify the hearts. There are du'as that Rasulullah taught us related to heart even. As one of the du'as he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, اللَّهُمَّ يَا مُصَرِّفَ الْقُلُوبِ صَرِّفْ قُلُوبَنَا عَلَىٰ طَاعَتِكَ. اللَّهُمَّ يَا مُثَبِّتَ الْقُلُوبِ ثَبِّتْ قُلُوبَنَا عَلَىٰ دِينِكَ. These are du'a that Rasulullah taught us related to heart. These adhkar helps us to purify our heart. Speaking truth. Rasulullah said in the hadith, لا يستقيم إيمان عبد حتى يستقيم قلبه ولا يستقيم قلبه حتى يستقيم لسانه. أولا أدلكم على شيء إذا فعلتموه تحاببتم أفشوا السلام بينكم. Your heart, your iman cannot be straight. لا يستقيم إيمان عبد until your heart is straight. And how your heart can be straight? If your tongue is straight. If your tongue is remembering Allah. You are not lying. You are always trying to be a sadiq. Speaking truth, regardless of the situation. That will help you to keep your heart also straight. And then Rasulullah said a beautiful advice. Should I tell you something? If you do it, it will bring mahabba and love among you. Afshu salama baynakum. Spread salam amongst yourself. Too much love. Sometimes we are in a gathering, especially a gathering where we don't remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should try our best. Any gathering that we sit in, we always try to mention something about Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تكثر الضحك فإن كثرة الضحك تميت القلب. Don't have the excess love, because excessive love will make your heart dead. Dead. Your heart will die. Because Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, once he said, if you know what I know, if you know what I know, you will laugh less and you will cry more. You will cry more. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith, لا تكثر الكلام بغير ذكر الله فإن كثرة الكلام بغير ذكر الله تعالى قسوة للقلب وإن أبعد الناس من الله القلب القاسي. Do not indulge in excessive talk except when remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Excessive talking without the remembrance of Allah azza wa jal hardens the heart, and those will be the farthest from Allah azza wa jal who have the hard heart. Another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about The memorization of the Quran is also one of the way to keep our heart pure. As he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ الَّذِي لَيْسَ فِي جَوْفِهِ شَيْءٌ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ كَالْبَيْتِ الْخَرْبِ. Indeed, the one who does not have the Quran inside him, meaning he did not memorize anything from the Quran, is like the ruined house. Another hadith, a beautiful hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أُدْعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَنْتُمْ مُوقِنُونَ بِالْإِجَابَةِ وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَسْتَجِيبُ دُعَاءَ مِنْ قَلْبٍ غَافِلٍ لَهُ. That whenever you are remembering Allah, your heart should not be ghafil. You should not be heedless about the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are some diseases of the heart also, like envy and all that, we don't have time to go in. But let me conclude with these two things. And that is one of the things that can help us. Because sometimes we see, okay, is my heart is alive or not? Is my heart is a sound heart or not? Is my heart has a marad or not? How I can judge? That is a question that can come in our mind. Right? So what is the criteria? How we can judge that my heart is not weak or my heart is sound heart? You know, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he mentioned beautiful things. He mentioned three things. He said, "Utlub qalbaka fi thalathi mawatin." Check your heart in these three occasions. If you find in these three occasions that your heart, you can judge if your heart is sound heart or it has some marad. It needs some improvement. The first thing he said, "Inda sama'il Quran." Subhanallah. When you listen to the Quran, what happens to you? What happens to you in the month of Ramadan, especially? Do you just count those 5 minutes equals to 2 units? If it becomes 6 or 7 minutes, you are kind of worried, or you enjoy the recitation of the Quran? What happens to you when you listen to the Quran? Wallahi, it's something very, very important. Sometimes we talk, I am talking, you're listening. Most of the time we think about others. Put it on yourself. And I have to put on myself. What happens to me when I listen to the ayat of Allah? When I recite the ayat of Allah? What is the state of my heart? Because it should fill with the fear and mahabba of Allah. الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. Allah says, وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. When the ayat of Allah is being recited to them, their iman increases. So what happens to you, what happens to me, when we sit and recite the Quran? Is there anything that happens to our heart? Do we feel that our iman has been increased or not? So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said that check yourself on these three occasions. One of the things he said radiallahu anhu, that عند سماع القرآن وفي مجالس الذكر. In the gathering where people they are mentioning about Allah, what happens to you? Do you just, you know, try to leave that gathering as soon as possible? Or you are sitting there, or sometime maybe in the khutbah, what happens? You are thinking about the stuff that you are going to do after the prayer, or you really try to think over that how I can improve myself. What is the thing that I can take with me so I can improve? That is one of the purposes of the khutbah, by the way. Why it's once in a week? So we can take something, so we can try to improve ourselves in next 5 or 6 days. Again, we come back on next Jum'ah, try to take one more thing. If we just take one thing in one khutbah, how about in a year? How about in a year? You can have around 48 to 50 things that we can improve in ourselves. Make it half, maybe 25 in a year. And what's our age now? But most of the time, maybe we think differently. I think maybe that this is for you guys, and you think it is for someone else. No, this is first of all for myself. and then it is for you. So Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he says, عند سماع القرآن وفي مجالس الذكر, check your heart, وفي أوقات الخلوة. Allahu Akbar. Check your state of heart when you are alone. Nobody is seeing you. And you can do whatever you want. What is the state of your heart? Sometime you could not sleep at night. So what do? If you cannot sleep, did you ever think that, okay, let me get up and read Quran? Let me get up and pray to Allah Azza wa Jal. Or you say, okay, let me watch that movie or that drama. What happens to us when we are in khalwa? What happens to us when we are alone? What is the state of our heart when no one is there? But as we know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, مَا يَكُونُ مِن نَجْوَى ثَلَاثَةٍ إِلَّا هُوَ رَابِعُهُمْ. You are in a najwa, you're in a gathering, Allah says, if you are two, he is the third one. If you are three, he is the fourth one. If you are four, he is the fifth one. وَهُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ. Wherever you are, he is with you. He is watching you. So Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said these three things. And then he said, فَإِلَّمْ تَجِدْهُ فِي هَذِهِ الْمَوَاطِنِ. If you don't find your heart connected with Allah in these three occasions, فَاسْأَلِ اللَّهَ أَن يَمُنَّ عَلَيْكَ بِقَلْبٍ فَإِنَّهُ لَا قَلْبَ لَكَ. Then ask Allah Azza wa Jal for a qalb, for a heart, because you don't have the heart. And look at Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, and we'll conclude that inshaAllah. He said, Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, مُصِيبَةٌ تُقْبِلُ بِهَا عَلَى اللَّهِ مُصِيبَةٌ تُقْبِلُ بِهَا عَلَى اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْ نِعْمَةٍ تُنْسِيكَ ذِكْرَ اللَّهِ. Subhanallah. مُصِيبَة, any calamity that brings you closer to Allah is better than a ni'mah, than a blessing that leads you to forget Allah Azza wa Jal. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله الواحد الأحد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. قال سبحانه, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي, يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين, اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين, وأيد الإسلام والمسلمين, وأذل الشرك والمشركين, ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين. اللهم يا مصرف القلوب, صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك. اللهم يا مثبت القلوب, ثبت قلوبنا على دينك. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين, واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين, اللهم ارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين. ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم, وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.